Today I'm gonna teach you how to take off that ugly wrap that you have been wanting to change for a really long time and you cannot see and support seeing because you hate it, and restaining your shells in such a way that's gonna look nice and it's not gonna be weird. So first thing to do is obviously to take out all of the hardware. Oh man. What the heck? Oh man, this is like in really bad conditions. And it smells really bad. So I took all of the hardware out and actually the wrap is already not starting good. It's like literally falling apart. And well, I at least think that it's not gonna be that difficult to take it off. And then we're gonna remove the wrap with a heat gun.
Yeah.
You are basically gonna put the heat only on the part where there's the glue, and with something flat, like this thing, I have no idea what's the name, you're gonna take it out. To remove the glue, use the heat gun in a lower mode, and just like RWR says, try not to damage the shell with it, so just be careful with it. Oh wait, that's it? Like seriously, that easy? I'm not gonna stain the tom with the compressor, which is somewhere up there. Which I have done that with my drum kit, and I really recommend you to do so if you know how to paint with a compressor with airbrush. It's a lot better and it's a lot cleaner. However, I take in mind that most of you actually may not have one, or at least not the airbrush and everything that comes with it. It's not that expensive, to be honest, if you really want to do it right, but I'm gonna teach you how to do it by hand in such a way that you can still do it at home, for example, or if you don't have a workplace and stuff like that. Also use the 3M kit, which I sanded from the thickest to the thinnest and make it sure that it will be all nice and smooth and consistent. I always find it very important to protect the bearing edges, so the first thing I do is I spend a couple of hours putting like painter's tape around the shell. It takes a while to be precise and everything, so it doesn't look like weird, but it has the good results, which is that it does not damage the inside when you spray gun it or when you are staining it. You of course don't want to paint the inside and don't want to fill it in with all kind of ugliness, and yeah, just stay clean with it. Try to take some distance from the spray gun and don't try to like spray it very near, because then the spread is very short and it's way too dense. It's gonna look really horrible. So try to take 30 centimeters at least. Make a couple of tryouts in a piece of paper or a piece of carton, a piece of wood that you're not using, whatever it might be, just, you know, practice your vertical motion and your horizontal one. I personally use the vertical only, and that has to do that it's more consistent into following a circle, and especially being horizontal level with the shell, then it's a lot easier to complete the entire layer at once instead of actually having to double spray it or something like that. And once you've finished your layer, you let it dry, and then might take you half an hour or so, and then you continue with the second layer, you wait, third layer, you wait, and so on. For my drum kit, if I remember correctly, I have done 8 layers of stain and 2 of clear coat, and in this shell I have only done 2 of stain. And the stain normally it's enough. I would recommend you to still put some clear coat, it's not necessarily necessary. That depends per the bottle that you buy. Just, you know, read the instructions, make sure that you understand fully what you're applying to it. Not to make any mistake or anything that you shouldn't do with your shell. In other words, ruining your shell. For my drum kit, I took the thinnest grid that I had and I made sure that every piece was nice and consistent, that it was equal everywhere, especially that I had a spot where it was a bit ruined, so I could actually correct that. And because there are some layers, you're actually having some space for it, so it's gonna be fine. Then I used a Scotch Bite to sand it to perfection, as I like to call it, which is to make it nice and smooth and everything, that it looks polished. If you want glossy shells, then you're gonna have to take a polish kit and use the instructions with that. I have not done it yet, but there are, yeah, some tutorials with that. Probably will do it so in the future. But yeah, you know, you just have to use the machine and yeah.